Given the profit function, where p of x is in hundreds of dollars, and x is the number of computers produced and sold, we want to answer the following questions. We first want to determine p of 500 and interpret the meaning of this. So to evaluate p of 500, we'll replace x with 500 in the profit equation. And to save some time, I've already evaluated this. It comes out to 1,630. But now remember, this is in hundreds of dollars. So we need to multiply this by 100 to determine the total profit from producing and selling 500 computers. So this means the profit from producing and selling 500 computers is $163,000. Again, this is 1,630 times 100 to get the total profit. Now number two, they want us to determine the marginal profit at x equals $500 and then interpret the results. Well, the marginal profit function is just the derivative of the profit function. So let's start by determining the marginal profit function. So p prime of x is going to be equal to negative 0.002 times the derivative of x squared. That'll be negative 0.004x plus the derivative of 4.5x would be 4.5. The derivative of 120 is 0. So here's our marginal profit function, and now we need to evaluate this at x equals 500. And again, to save some time, I've already determined this value. This is equal to 2.5. But again, this would be in hundreds of dollars. And the marginal profit tells us the approximate change in profit from selling the x plus 1th item, or in this case, the 500 first item. So from this, we can conclude that the approximate profit from the 501st computer is 2.5 times 100, or $250. So this is one of the major uses of the marginal profit function. It tells us the amount of profit from producing and selling the x plus 1th item. So if x is 500, it tells us the amount of profit from the 501st computer. And then number three asks us to estimate the total profit after 501 computers are sold. So this 250 is just the profit from selling the 501st computer. So the total profit from producing and selling 501 computers would be approximately equal to total profit from producing and selling 500 computers plus the marginal profit at x equals 500. So using the results from number one and number two, we know this is going to equal $163,000. Plus $250. So this will give us the approximate total profit from producing and selling 501 computers, $163,250. Let's go and take a look at one more question. We want to estimate the total profit after 502 computers are sold using the marginal profit at x equals 500. So the idea here is the total profit after selling 502 computers will be approximately equal to total profit of producing and selling 500 computers plus 2 times the marginal profit at x equals 500. We're multiplying this by 2 because remember, this tells us the approximate profit of selling the x plus 1th item. So if we're selling two more, we'd have to multiply that by 2. So we'd have $163,000 plus 2 times $250, giving us an approximate profit of $163,500 from producing and selling 502 computers. I do want to take a quick look at the graph of the profit function. Remember, the value of the derivative at x equals 500 represents the slope of the tangent line at this point here. So when we're using the marginal profit to make approximations about the total profit, we're actually using the slope of this tangent line to make approximations for the actual profit function. And notice that as long as x is near 500, this line is a fairly good approximation of the actual function, and therefore it does give us good approximations. So I think we'll go ahead and stop here for this example. I hope you found it helpful.